Republicans in the House still seem gung-ho on impeaching President Biden. And of course, earlier this past week, we did have Kevin McCarthy go on Fox News saying that the evidence, which doesn't actually even exist technically, is kind of pointing towards this evolving into an impeachment inquiry. And that's what's happening over in the House. But over in the Senate, according to a new report, Republicans starting to get a little uneasy, almost starting to freak out a little bit, because they understand and they remember history that impeaching President Biden on BS kind of made up things, sure, maybe you can get him on it, but it's really just technically a technicality. But you could still probably impeach him because you do have the numbers in the House. So maybe you can, maybe you can't. But either way, it's not going to work out well, is the message basically coming from Republicans in the Senate. Now, here's why this is important, and I've mentioned this a dozen times. I'll mention it a dozen more times by the end of this year. You have Steve Daines, Republican senator, who is now the head of the National Republican Senatorial Committee, which is the fundraising arm of the Senate Republicans. Steve Daines came out a couple months ago and said, if Republicans do not take back the Senate in 2024, we will not have another chance to take it back till the election of the year 2030. So Republicans in the Senate understand how important 2024 is. You have more Democrats up than Republicans. You have a couple of close races already where the Democratic incumbent is not going to be there. Kyrsten Sinema and Joe Manchin. Joe Manchin's already going to get his clock cleaned. Jim Justice has a 22-point advantage over him in the polls right now. So Republicans can pick up a lot, and if they don't, they're screwed till the next decade. That is the big reason Republicans don't want to touch this impeachment, because most importantly, they know they don't have the numbers in the Senate to actually impeach the guy. So it's all fruitless to begin with. They can't convict and remove him. All he can do is be impeached in the House, much like Donald Trump was twice. But more importantly, much like Bill Clinton was in 1998. And unfortunately, we actually still have members of the U.S. Senate who voted in that impeachment. They're still serving because we don't have term limits because we're a dumb country, but they remember what happened to them. And that was the first time in the 1998 midterms, because the impeachment happened right before the midterms, it was the first time where the president's party actually picked up seats in the House in the midterms. Bill Clinton's popularity skyrocketed after he was impeached. And Democrats won big in those midterm elections. That Republicans were projected to win big, but then they impeached him and then they didn't. And that's exactly what the Republicans in the Senate, according to these new reports, are basically saying. Like, listen, we've done this before. We've gone down this path. It did not end well for us. It ended very badly. And you're doing the exact same thing here. You're going to screw us over. We're not only going to lose the Senate for the rest of the decade, we're going to lose the House, and most importantly, we're going to lose that presidential election. Y'all are making the same mistakes that Republicans made in 1998, but the Republicans in the House aren't listening to those same Republicans that were still in the Senate in 1998. They remember it all too well, and they see exactly where Republicans in the House are pushing them. On the other side, though, by the way, let's assume they do uncover big crimes. Let's assume they're able to impeach him and, hell, then convict and remove him from office. You know what that does for the Democrats, right? That actually opens up the field. According to the latest round of polling, you still have half of the Democrats in this country who say, we don't want Biden to be the nominee. We don't want the other two people. We don't want Marianne Williamson, and we definitely don't want, you know, RFK Jr., Democrats say. But we would like somebody else to enter the race. So assuming Republicans end up getting rid of Biden, you're only doing the Democratic Party a favor, because then we'll have an open primary. People can come in, good people. And boom, you actually solve a lot of our problems. So no matter which way you slice this, impeaching Biden is going to help the Democrats no matter what. Ring of Fire has fresh content 7 days a week. So if you want to be reminded about it, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, hit the little bell to be notified every time a new video goes up.